Hi friends, welcome back to another video tutorial on Codesys. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a combo box to modify a variable in a visualization project using Codesys. I've already created a project and added a visualization. If you open it and go to the visualization toolbox, you will see two combo boxes under COM controls, combo box integer and combo box array. A combo box is an element that allows user to select one item from a drop-down list of predefined options. When the user clicks an entry, the index of the entry is written to a variable and the value changes accordingly. Let's start with the combo box integer. Go to the visualization and insert the combo box integer to the project. To use this box, we need to declare an integer variable. Go back to the visualization and click on the element. For the variable property, select the variable that we declared. Save the project and start the simulation. As you can see now, I can assign values to the variable using this box. When I select an entry from the box, the value of the integer changes. When an option is selected, it will be highlighted in green. To display text matching a list, we can create a text list. So for each entry, we can show a text instead of a number. To create a text list, right-click on the application and from Add Object, select Text List. Under the ID, write the numbers and under the default, write the text that you need to show for each value. From the properties, select the text list. Let's start the simulation and see the change. Now, instead of numbers, text are displayed. Another option is the image pool. An image will be displayed for each entry. Like adding a text list, right-click the application and from Add Object, select Image Pool. Click here to select the image for each ID. Log in again. Now we can show an image for each value. With the next property, we can adjust the size and look of the displayed list. Let me, for example, change the row height to 50 pixels. Login. As you can see, I changed the row height this way. Here we can change the range of values to be changed. Click inside this box and then define the minimum and maximum value. I'm going to set them to 0 and 10. Let's see the changes. Now we can change the value between 0 and 10. If you activate this property, then just the values that we have defined in the text list will be displayed. As you can see, because I've just defined values 1, 2, and 3 in the text list, only these values are displayed. All right, now we know how to use ComboBox integer in our visualization. We can use this combo box to provide a compact way to present multiple options and let the user pick one. For example, changing the preset value of a counter inside the visualization. The next one is the combo box array. This element shows values of an array as a list box. When the visualization user clicks an entry, the array index of the entry is written to an integer variable. So for this element, we need two variables of type array and integer. Let's say I want to have three different items to be selected by the user in the visualization, options 1, 2, 3. I'm going to declare a variable of data type array. The size should be 1 to 3 or 0 to 2 because we have 3 options. We can determine the start values to be shown when an option is selected. Option 1, option 2, and option 3. Then we need to declare an integer variable to assign a number to each option. In properties, assign the index variable to the property variable. For the data array, select the array variable. As you can see, as I press enter, we have these columns appearing here. For now, I don't change anything here. Let's start the simulation. Initially, the index is 0 and the combo box says we have not yet selected any item. Click on the box to display the items. Selecting the first one, the index becomes 1. With option 2, the value will be 2. It's exactly like a combo box integer when we use a text list. But imagine we want to have option 2 with two different modes, option 2A and option 2B. Let me change the names to car and color to see the difference better. We want to choose between three cars with two different colors. The first method is to make a text list with six possible options and use a combo box integer or array. The second method is using a two-dimensional array. The first dimension is for the number of columns. I need one column for car, another one for color. So the first dimension is 1 to 2. Since we have 6 rows for 6 different options, the second dimension will be 1 to 6. Login. As you see, in this way, we can select between these different options, and with each one, a value is written to the index variable. With these properties, we can adjust the width, change the color or size. Okay, we are finished now with another video tutorial on codices. In this video, we learn how to use combo box, integer and array in a visualization of codices to show and change the value of a variable. I hope it was helpful to you. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. Bye, friends.